Here's my dinner for tonight. Golden chicken. Here's two chicken breasts. Look how greasy this is. Fries. Here's a thigh. Oh, look how greasy this is. Just the way I like it. The greasy, the chicken, that one's good. Unless you're looking to watch your weight. This is my dinner. Oh, and having Diet Coke too. I'm having KFC fried chicken for dinner tonight. This here's my favorite piece right here, the chicken breast. So nice and juicy and tasty. There we go.
Tomorrow night, a light wind off the lake and cool temperatures, especially in the outlying areas, down in the upper 20s in some spots. So a chilly Thursday morning, but during the day on Thursday, a nice little warm-up. Winds will be southeast, so cooler lakeside, warmer inland. The clouds increase Thursday night. Here comes some rain showers, but the air is very dry. So I think on Friday morning, maybe a couple of sprinkles at most. Most of the showers, I think, will hold off till later Friday afternoon, and especially Friday night. The forecast for tonight, 33 degrees right in the city, down to 29 in the outlying areas. The evening clouds are now slowly starting to clear out. Winds will diminish, so getting more comfortable. For tomorrow, 50 degrees as an average daytime high, but turning cooler along the lake in the afternoon. Our northwest wind in the morning will turn northeast in the afternoon to drop those lakeside temperatures, a sun-cloud mix.
Look how nice and tasty and juicy this is. That's just the way I like it. Thank you, KFC, for making the best fried chicken ever.
Showers and thunder showers, a little cooler with scattered showers Monday and 53. That's it for weather. Here's Mary.
Sounds good. Thank you. In health news, a new study finds that many patients are reluctant to undergo a colonoscopy, even though it is considered the best way to screen for colon cancer. Patients are more likely to opt for what's called a simple fecal occult blood test that checks on bleeding, which is a sign of colon cancer. Now, many patients do not like all the prep and the invasiveness that comes with a colonoscopy. The benefit, though, of the procedure is that it can be done every 10 years, while a fecal blood test should be done every year. A study published in the journal Cancer shows a link between frequent dental x-rays and developing a certain brain tumor called mediangioma. Researchers found patients who had bite wing x-rays at least once a year had a 40 to 90% greater risk of the tumor. They say this doesn't mean you should stop going to dentists, nor does it prove x-rays cause tumors. They say do annual x-rays. They say that annual x-rays do, however, put you at greater risk.
Well, the number of American teenagers giving birth is dropping. Health officials say the number of teenagers giving birth dropped 9% from 2009 to 2010. There were 34.3 births for every 1,000 teens in 2010. That's the lowest it's been since 1946. The decrease is attributed to both fewer teens having sexual intercourse and the increased use of contraception. That's the good news. The bad news, the U.S. birth rate is still among the highest among the industrialized countries.
What do you think the average internet surfer spends most of their time clicking on?
It's not toxic, it's not iCloud. It's not. All the world says, porn. So we're talking about the fact that the article cites a report by Street Tech, which suggests an average visit to a typical news site, 3 to 6 minutes. Surfers spending upwards of 15 to 20 minutes on porn sites. The report estimates about 30% of all internet traffic involves pornographic sites.
Proving people really do love Facebook, a Washington State fugitive is on the run, but it's not stopping him from updating his status. 26-year-old Travis Nicolaysen is wanted on multiple charges, but is still updating his page and responding to friends' comments. Some friends are even offering advice on where to go, while others are pushing the man to turn himself in. Despite the updates, police haven't managed to catch up with him.
Well, some drivers in Texas got to fill up their cars for a steal. $1 a gallon.
It was a technical glitch at this gas station in Pasadena, Texas. It changed the price at the pump on Monday night. When the news spread like wildfire on Facebook, people came from as far away as they could to take advantage of the bargain, which lasted several hours. One store employee discovered the mistake, and once that happened, the pumps were shut down.
A teen pop star lending his voice to promoting a movie about bullying.
And a woman who just wouldn't leave Alec Baldwin alone is under arrest. That and more in the buzz.
The woman accused of stalking actor Alec Baldwin is now under arrest in New York City. 40-year-old Genevieve Savorin is charged with 5 misdemeanor counts, including aggravated harassment and stalking. The Montreal native has been ordered to stay away from the 30 Rock star and to avoid all contact with the actor. Her arrest comes after a series of text messages and emails that she sent to Baldwin after the two met in 2010. Singer Justin Bieber is lending his support to the new documentary, Bully. The company which produced the PG-13 film says Bieber is letting his song, Born to be Somebody, be used in the commercials. In a statement, Bieber said he hopes his fans will see Bully with their friends.
Mashed potatoes and gravy.
Bully opens nationwide on Friday. The show must go on for Jennifer Hudson. The singer and actress will go through with a scheduled performance on American Idol this week, even though jury selection is underway in the case of the man accused of killing her mother, brother, and nephew. Opening statements are scheduled for later this month. Hudson could be called as a witness. She will perform on Thursday night's results show. And that's the buzz.
The King of the Jungle is now the King of Broadway.
The Lion King is now the number one Broadway show of all time. Beat out Phantom of the Opera for the top spot. Record-breaking $853 million on Broadway. A musical based on the hit Disney film that debuted in 1997.
Have you seen it?
No.
I did. I love it. It's great.
Which on Broadway?
On Broadway, yeah. Just a great visual. It's really wonderful.
And look, I mean, just the clips are
amazing. Oh, yeah. Especially for kids.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good stuff. Well, do you look for bacon? I know you do.
I love bacon. I belong to the I Love Bacon Facebook page. Some people would actually die for bacon. Details on the bacon-wrapped coffin.
I'm Ann State tonight at 6. It starts with a discovery in this garage. Investigators say it was full of stolen loot from homes that had been burglarized. The victims all had one thing in common. They had recently lost a loved one. Did their grief make them a target? We're there as the man accused of being the obituary burglar appears in court. Fox 6 News at 6.
For the celebrity who goes to the airport, and while being screened by the TSA, they go,
is that a joint in your pocket, or?
Tonight at 6:30 on Fox 6.
Shopping for Rover, Titan Con, Flex Service, Name Brand, Experience Sale. Like 20% off sandals for the whole family, men's, women's, and kids. Better hurry, this sale ends soon.
Selection, service, name brands, and the second pair is always half price. Visit online at BrokenShoes.com. at My Popeyes Chicken Bonafide Originals. And right now, for a limited time, you can get 3 pieces of my amazing bonafide chicken. A leg, a wing, a thigh, and a biscuit for just $3.49. That's right, honey, $3.49.
Love that chicken from Popeyes.
I'm Eric Covey, and I approve this message. You know our government borrows 38 cents on every dollar it spent. We have more debt to our economy than all but 3 European countries. This is not just an economic crisis, it's a moral crisis. The path the politicians gave us is destroying our children's future. I'm Eric Covey, that's why.
Chicken? Chicken? And more chicken. I'm in chicken heaven. And this is my dinner for tonight. Tyson chicken strips. Look at that tasty chicken. Such plump, tasty portions of chicken. This is my lunch here. Tyson chicken strips. Thank you.